all their lives.
Draw one by Boston. McNabb is on with John Wensink, who's dressed for action tonight. Lalonde is not, Rattel is not, and Gary Doak. Clark tipped out to the Islanders' line, and Clark Gillies with it. O'Reilly crashes into the corner. McNabb lost it to Goring. Goring to Sutter. Sutter against Rick Smith. Forced deep. And here goes O'Reilly and Gillies in a fierce battle. O'Reilly pounding Gillies. Oh, O'Reilly flailed away with left, pounding Gillies. And O'Reilly falls down. You'd have to say sheer exhaustion from pounding away on Gillies. Terry O'Reilly and Clark Gillies. And Terry really rattled him. And Harry Sinden obviously is going to match O'Reilly against Gillies. For Gillies gave Middleton a bit of a going over last night in that line match.
Fred, the Bruins don't forget. They have long memories. And they were talking about that last night in the dressing room. They're very upset with Gillies for taking a run at Rick Middleton. He's one of those players who you just don't do that to, and he's going to pay the price for that.
All right, with the score of Boston nothing and Islanders nothing, let's pause for this message.
Okay, you have to be prepared to take a hit after you give up the puck from time to time in this game. And that's what Gillies does. He lost the puck. He saw O'Reilly coming. O'Reilly ran at him, barely avoiding a charging call. They just decided to go at it. That was a battle of the super heavyweights. The winner of this fight has to take on Larry Holmes. Gillies got the first one in, but O'Reilly answered with several more shots. They both wind up in the penalty box for 5 minutes at 2 minutes and 46 seconds.
Lefty O'Reilly.
Okay, you have to be prepared to take a hit after you give up the puck from time to time in this game. And that's what Gillies does. He lost the puck. He saw O'Reilly coming. O'Reilly ran at him, barely avoiding a charging call. They just decided to go at it. That was a battle of the super heavyweights. The winner of this fight has to take on Larry Holmes. Gillies got the first one in, but O'Reilly answered with several more shots. They both wind up in the penalty box for 5 minutes at 2 minutes and 46 seconds. Oh, they say you can see everything all over the ice with the cage. Apparently you can.
20 seconds left in the period. Sutter moves it in on Cheevers, tipped away, McClellan up to O'Reilly, blocked, Goring kept it in. Milbury trying to come out. Stolen by Goring, but fortunately, Sutter was still in the zone as Goring tried to bring it in. And Goring having something to say with Milbury. Gillies starting to move on Milbury. Seven seconds left in the period. Faceoff will be outside the line. O'Reilly and Gillies may resume. They drop their gloves and they go. Round two. O'Reilly is knocked down by Gillies. They will both be going out as they resume again. Clark Gillies and Terry O'Reilly. Round two.
Fred, the smartest man in this building turns out to be Claude Bouchard for getting out of the way of that one in time.
So they'll be going out, and I don't know if anything else, anybody else will. Bouchard is talking to O'Reilly. And look at the clock. All this with just 7 seconds left in the first period. The Islanders leading 1-0.
This is very indicative of the big change that I've seen in the Islanders. They've now got players who are willing to step in and protect their own teammates. It's something they've never had in the past. That beef originally was between Milbury and Goring. Gillies stepped in immediately. This is something a little bit different from the Islanders that we've seen in years gone by.
1953, they each get 5 minutes again for fighting.
In the first period, and the line's going to have to be very alert here because it could break out again at any moment as Sutter and Milbury continue to lash out at each other. And now O'Reilly and Gillies drop the gloves, and here they go.
Gillies hit him with good right off the start.
Gillies pummeling Terry O'Reilly. And the linesman quickly stepped in.
Clark Gillies caught him with a lap right at the start, the shot. O'Reilly on his heels. This time it's Clark Gillies on the offensive.
Claude Béchard holding off O'Reilly. Scampanello doing the same with Gillies.
He knows exactly what to do. It's 5 minutes it's going to be, so he heads for the dressing room. There's 7 seconds to go on the clock. O'Reilly wants to argue, and I don't understand why.